Hey guys, Cammy here. Today I thought I would make a video about how I set up my photo card binders and kind of make this a how-to video. I feel like a lot of people are starting to collect photo cards and albums and maybe aren't exactly sure how to do those things. There are many different ways people store their photo cards and different ways people collect, but today I'll be showing you step by step how I set up my photo card binders and the materials I use. So let's get into it. Step 1, deciding what to collect. So, the first step in setting up your photo card binder and just collection in general is deciding what to collect. I'm showing you my ranking sheets, and this is how I organize who and what I collect from each group. I can delve a bit deeper into how I decided what to collect in a different video if you guys want, but for now, I'll just summarize. I collect all member photo cards from ATs because they're my ultimates. But for my other ultimates, BTS, I only collect Yoongi's photo cards. Now, you may choose to collect all members from every single group you like, but it's just personal preference. But don't feel bad if you only collect your bias from every group you like, because not everyone's financially able to collect every single card for every single member, especially if you stay in multiple groups. My reasoning for collecting all members of ATs is that they're rookies, so their photo cards are a bit cheaper and easier to find than BTS, a group that's been around for a while and are super popular. Step 2, gathering materials. The reason step 1 is figuring out who and what to collect is so that you can use this to organize your binders. I collect 12 groups, 3 of which I consider ultimates, and therefore I collect a bit more things from those. So I'm going to have 2 binders, one for my ultimates and one for my other groups. You don't have to do it like this. You could organize your binders by boy groups and girl groups, but it all depends on who you collect. The binders I use are 2-inch durable binders from Avery. You can also get creative with colors and how you want to decorate them. I use colorful cardstock as a cover, and I'm using my own stickers that I have in my Etsy store to label the cover. The link to my Etsy store will be down below if you want to check out my stickers and use them for your binders. The next thing you'll need are pocket sleeves. The ones you'll use most often are the 9 pocket sleeves. All the links to the materials I use will be in the description, by the way, if you want to check them out. You'll also want penny sleeves to put your photo cards in, as this adds a bit of extra protection. These can also be used when trading your photo cards. You also can get a 4 pocket, 3 pocket, and 2 pocket sleeves for other random items that may come in your albums. But you can also use sheet protectors and just place them inside. It all depends on how financially able you are and how much you care. Now that we have our materials, let's move on to step 3. Step 3, organizing your binder. Now that you have all your materials, you can begin to set up your binder. First, you should decide what order you want to place your groups in. I do mine in alphabetical order, but you can do this any way you like. When placing a group in a binder, I like to section off with a piece of cardstock and a sheet protector. This helps me keep organized so I know where groups are. So here I'm making a section for BTS. I like to keep a cohesive look with the same color of cardstock and a binder label that matches the cover. I just write BTS on the sticker and put the cardstock in my binder. Next are the pocket sleeves that will hold your photo cards and other random items. First, I start with the regular size photo cards. I take a 9 pocket sleeve and arrange my photo cards in order by album release. This is because I only collect Yoongi's cards for BTS. For groups where you collect all members, you may want to organize by member or by era. Either one is fine. Then, I use 2, 3, and sometimes 4 pocket sleeves to fit the abnormally shaped photo cards, like the ones from School Love Affair or Wings era, and also postcards from the album. Since I only collect Yoongi for BTS, I keep my group cards on their own page, but for ATs where I collect all members, I'll typically keep the group card with the members' photo cards. Step 4, making your binder cute and functional. So by now you should know how your binder is going to be set up, and what you're using your materials for. This final step is making your binder look cute, but also be functional for your collection. If we look at my BTS collection, for example, I'm missing quite a few photo cards. So what I like to do in order to know what I still need is to save spaces for the cards I'm missing. How I do this is I find a template of all of Yoongi's photo cards. Typically, I go to Moonsoul on Instagram, and in their highlights, they have a whole template just for Yoongi's photo cards. They have this for many, many different groups, and each member of every group and entire eras for groups. It just depends on what you're collecting. I'll use this to help me arrange the cards and save spaces for the ones I don't have. Next, I'll create the inserts. These are just pieces of cardstock that I cut to fit my 9-pocket sleeves. The dimensions depend on your brand of 9-pocket sleeves, but I'll put on the screen the size you should cut if you have the Ultra Pro 9-pocket sleeves like me. Next, once I cut these out, I take a mini binder label and I write the album name of the photo card I need. I use my own stickers from my Etsy shop to keep things looking cohesive, but you can use post-it notes or just a scrap piece of paper. Something else I use from my Etsy store are these coming in the mail stickers. They help me keep track of what I have coming so I don't accidentally buy two of the same photo card. Another thing these colored cardstock inserts are good for is decorating. For ATs, I use different colored paper to put behind the photo cards so each era looks different. You could do this as well for your groups. You could even color code each group you stand. Like NCT gets green cards and BTS gets blue for me. Alright guys, hope you enjoyed the video and that it helped you start your own photo card binder. Stay tuned for the next video where I'll be setting up my new binders with you guys. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below and I'll be happy to help. See you soon!